Hi, let's discuss SLR one parcel. SLR stands for simply LR and one is for look ahead symbol. The SLR methods begins with LR0 items and LR0 automata. SLR automata is same as LR0 automata, only difference will be in parsing table. I will discuss what is the difference. So let's see how we can construct a SLR parsing table. What are the rules for constructing SLR parsing table? There will be two parts, one for action and another will be for go to. In action, there will be all the terminal and dollar. In go to, there will be non-terminal. So there are some rules of action. First rule, if A derive alpha A beta is in II, and go to II A equal to IJ, then set action IA to SJ and S would be terminal. It is same as LR0 parsing table. If there is a go to, then write S with the state number, that is SJ, that SJ is for shift J. Then second rule, if A derive alpha dot, this is a reduction, is in II, then set action IA to RI for all A in fall of A and A should not be S dash. So this is different from LR parsing table. In LR parsing table, what we are doing, we are keeping RI in all column of action part. But here what you will do, we'll keep RI for all A in fall of A. Means we need to find fall of left hand side variable and we'll write that reduction in fall of LHS side variable. So this is different from LR parsing table. We need to keep reduction in fall of LHS variable. Next rule, if S dash derive S dot is in II, then set action I dollar to asset. It is same as LR0. If any conflict action result in the above rule, then we'll say the grammar is not SLR1. These are rules for action. Next check for go to. Go to will take all the non-terminal. And if go to IIA equal to IJ, then we'll simply write go to IA equal to J. In go to, we'll write J. In action, we'll write SJ. And go to, that will be with the non-terminal, whereas action will be with the terminal. All the rules are same as LR parsing table except this. We'll place reduction in fall of LHS side variable. If SLR1 parsing table is free from multiple entry, then the grammar is SLR grammar. Or you can say if it is free from any conflict like shift reduce conflict or reduce conflict, then the grammar is SLR grammar. We usually omit the one after SLR since we are not dealing with the parser having more than one look ahead symbol. We are dealing with the parser having one look ahead symbol. So we omit this one. We generally say SLR parser, SLR grammar. We don't say repeatedly SLR1. For SLR1 parsing, grammar should be unambiguous. So you can say SLR1 grammar is a unambiguous grammar, but there are many unambiguous grammar that are not SLR1. This is important. In GATE 2021, one question asked from this statement that every SLR1 grammar is unambiguous, but every unambiguous grammar is not SLR1. In next lecture, I will discuss with example that how to construct SLR automata and parsing table. If this lecture is helpful for you, please like and subscribe. Thank you.